my name is Megan Anderson. I'm an extension field agronomist with Iowa State University. We talked about the depth of soybean planting this spring in dry soils, and we've also heard about issues this spring with planting corn into dry soils and getting them at the appropriate depth. So we're going to talk about why it's important to plant corn at 2 inches, or about 2 inches, and why it's important to get out and check, because we can have developmental issues with those corn plants when they're planted shallow. So this spring, more than other recent years, we've heard that people have had trouble actually getting corn in the ground. We know that we set our planters to a specific planting depth, and in a lot of years, our planters do a pretty good job of getting that seed in the ground where we want it to. This spring, people have had to use a lot more down pressure to actually get the corn in the ground to the depth that we need it to be at. And so here we actually have some corn that was planted at what I would consider to be a pretty appropriate depth. It's right at about 2 inches in the ground. And so we were actually able to get this into moisture this spring. And so if I dig this plant out, this was planted 8 days ago, but you can see it's got nice root development here and this nice coleoptile. So this is a protective sheath that's actually covering the leaves. And so as soon as this reaches sunlight at the soil surface, the leaves are actually going to come out of it, and that's when we'll actually start to be able to see that pretty corn, be able to row it. But this was at a really good depth in the ground in order to get it into consistent moisture, and so we should see really good consistent emergence from this corn stand here. Now, if we run into issues where maybe you plant and you think you're planting at 2 inches, but you're 3/4 of an inch shallower than that, we're going to run into problems, especially this year with the moisture, where we're not going to get consistent germination on these seeds. And so you can see here, this is a case where we were really shallow, probably not even an inch in the ground. And in this case, this seed actually sat in dry soil, and it looks like it hasn't even absorbed enough moisture to actually start that germination process. Whereas some of its neighboring seed have started that germination process, but these were planted on the same day as the one we just looked at. And you can see that they are just starting to produce that radicle out of it. So we can run into the same kinds of issues that we run into with soybeans, that we're going to get uneven emergence, but it's likely to be much more of a problem in the corn. And if these, if the soil dries out and the corn isn't able to continue that germination process, it can sit there for a little bit and wait for moisture, but there's a chance that the seed could die as well and we get some stand loss from it. Additionally, it's not just this concern of right at planting and having uneven emergence, but the way that the corn roots develop, because this seed and the growing point actually stays below the ground, it's really important that those roots are far enough in the soil that when it produces its permanent root system, it's able to be about 3/4 of an inch below the soil surface. And so the way that these are going to develop right now, the permanent root system that the plants develop are only going to be about 1/4 of an inch below the surface of the soil. So in dry conditions or in a situation where it can't develop those roots properly, we may end up with what we call floppy corn syndrome. So these plants are not going to be steady, they're not going to have good permanent root systems, and there's a good chance that we could lose them or suffer some pretty serious consequences later in the season as a result of it. So it's really important that, you know, pretty much all the corn's in the ground now, but it's really important that we got that in at the appropriate depth, and that if it wasn't at the appropriate depth, we realize what some of the potential issues are that are going to result from that. By the way, can we all just admire how pretty my nails look today?
They're amazing.
Aren't they sparkly? They're so pretty. Okay.
25 seconds.